Dear students, in this lecture we will discuss about cyclopentadienyl complexes. So cyclopentadienyl complexes, these are the complexes in which cyclopentadienyl will act as ligand with transition metal complexes or the lanthanides or the actinides. Generally, the transition metal complexes, they form such kind of complexes. So in this lecture we will discuss about the different aspects of cyclopentadienyl, the types of cyclopentadienyl complexes, their bonding and their preparation methods and their properties. A cyclopentadienyl ligand is a spectator ligand. So what do we mean by this spectator ligand? So spectator means the ligands, they cannot react chemically in the chemical reaction. And while the actor ligands, they generally react during the chemical reactions. So cyclopentadienyl, it is a spectator ligands. On the basis of the structure of the cyclopentadienyl complexes, it can be divided into three types. One is sandwich, and sandwich are known as generally metallocenes. Sandwich, like a sandwich, two cyclopentadienyl rings, they are present on the upper side and the lower side, and in between the two cyclopentadienyl rings, metal ion is present. So it is known as sandwich metallocene. Then second type is bent metallocene, and bent metallocene, in this case you will see that there are two cyclopentadienyl rings, but they are not sandwich type. So the two cyclopentadienyl rings, they bent. Okay, the third type of cyclopentadienyl complexes, they are known as piano stool or half sandwich. Half sandwich, you will see that the structure is like a piano stool. And half sandwich, why? Because there is only one cyclopentadienyl ring in these kind of cyclopentadienyl complexes. So these are the three type of cyclopentadienyl complexes. Here you will see the sandwich type of complexes, and the general formula is CP2M or MCP2. We can write CP is represented for representation for cyclopentadienyl, and you can see that one cyclopentadienyl ring is here and other is here, and in between these two cyclopentadienyl rings, the metal will become sandwiched. Okay, so now bent type metallocenes, they all also have two cyclopentadienyl rings, but other than the cyclopentadienyl rings, there are the other ligands also, and the number of other ligands may be 1, 2, or 3. So this become bent type because now the metal ion is not in the sandwich position between the two cyclopentadienyl rings. So it is known as bent cyclopentadienyl complex. It is bent metallocene, while this is metallocene. Now the third one is piano stool or half sandwich type of cyclopentadienyl complex. And here you will see the general formula is CPMLN. There is a cyclopentadienyl ligand and other, some other ligands may be present there. And one cyclopentadienyl. So due to presence of one cyclopentadienyl and the other ligands, its structure becomes piano stool. So in this piano stool, you will see that the cyclopentadienyl will act as the seat of the piano stool, while the other ligands, they will act as the legs of the piano stool. So there may be 3 legs, there may be 4 legs, or there may be 2 legs in the piano stool type of cyclopentadienyl complex. So this is half sandwich because there is only one cyclopentadienyl ring. So now there are other some important points on cyclopentadienyl ligand. So cyclopentadienyl, so there are two double bonds. Enyl means it has a negative charge, so it is also known as cyclopentadienide anion. So it is an anion. Cyclopentadienyl ring is actually cyclopentadiene plus 1 negative charge. So it is known as cyclopentadienide anion. It has delocalized structure. It has six electron system because 5 electrons of the 5 carbon atoms p orbitals and 1 electron as an anion. ऑल दिस सी एच एटम्स आर कोप्लेनर एक्चुअली एज इन केस ऑफ लाइक द केस ऑफ बेंजीन ऑल द सी एच एटम्स आर कोप्लेनर एंड ड्यू टू डीलोकलाइजेशन कार्बन कार्बन बॉन्ड लेंथ इज इक्वल दैट इज अराउंड 1.39 एंगस्ट्रॉम. सो द एक्चुअल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ साइक्लो पेंटाडाइनाइल इज द रेजोनेंस हाइब्रिड ऑफ दीज स्ट्रक्चर्स. So this is the resonance hybrid of these structures, and you will see that there are five carbon atom in the cyclopentadienyl ring with two double bonds diene-dienyl ring and dienyl, while there are two double bonds and one negative charge. So due to presence of this negative charge, it becomes a six electron species. So you can see that this negative charge may be on this carbon atom, may be on this carbon atom, may be on this, may be on this, or may be on this. So these are the resonance hybrid structures, or this is the resonance hybrid of these resonance degenerating structures. So it is having the delocalized system so that its bond length, it becomes equal, all the bond lengths become equals, that is equal to 1.39. The cyclopentadienyl can bind to eta 5 ligand as a eta 5 ligand, and also it can bind as eta 1 and eta 3 ligand. So cyclopentadienyl, when binds to the metal center, it can show 5 hepticity, 1 hepticity, or 3 hepticity. Because it is having two double bonds, so it can act as 5. It has 5 carbon atoms, so it can act as 5 carbon attaching to the metal center, 1 carbon may attach to the metal center, or 3 carbon may attach to the metal center. So I will show you with the help of the example. So here you can see the example that the cyclopentadienyl is like this. So it has negative charge here, and if we write it as like this, so it can, when it is added to this metal center, it can form a bond like this. It means all the five carbon atoms, they are joined with the metal center. So now it is a kind of eta 5 ligand. So it can be written as eta 5 cyclopentadienyl, because all the five carbon atoms, they are joined to the metal center. Now the other, in another way, it can bind to the metal center. So like this. This is another method of binding of this metal center, is this ligand, that only one carbon atom is attaching to this metal center. So it is eta 1 type cyclopentadienyl interaction. This is bonding. So only one carbon atom is attaching to this metal center. The third way of this attachment of the cyclopentadienyl with the metal center, that is this way. That 1, 2, 3, 3 carbon atom may be bonded with the metal center. So 3 carbon atom, when 3 carbon atom are bonded to the metal center, then it is known as eta 3 cyclopentadienyl interaction. So it can act as eta 5, eta 1, or eta 3 hepticity ligand, and these are the three forms by which it can attaches to the metal center. Examples, in this example you can see that it is acting as eta 5 in the ferrocene. Here it can act, one cyclopentadienyl ring is attached as eta 5 and other as eta 3, and in this case one cyclopentadienyl ring was attached as eta 5 and other as eta 1. So there may be possibility of joining of ligand as eta 5, eta 1, or eta 3 in the cyclopentadienyl metal complexes. One more important point regarding cyclopentadienyl ligand is that due to negative charge, cyclopentadienyl ligand is a base. So when it is a base, it is not a good pi acceptor ligand. So generally it increases the back donation from metal center to the other ligands. So here is the example. If you see that this is a cyclopentadienyl ligand and these are the other pi acceptor ligands, then you can see that because this cyclopentadienyl ligand is having a negative charge, so it is a good base. It can easily donate its electron pairs to the metal center, but cannot back bond with the metal and cannot accept electrons from the metal center easily, because it is acting as a base due to the negative charge. So it generally increases electron density on the metal center, so that this density can be decreased by further back donation to the other pi acceptor ligands. So this cyclopentadienyl ring will initiate or encourage the back bonding of the metal with the other pi acceptor ligands, because it has negative charge and it acts as a base and cannot back bond with the metal center. It is not a good pi acceptor ligand, so it increases the back bonding of this metal electrons with the other pi acceptor ligands. Now we will see the bonding in cyclopentadienyl complexes. So in cyclopentadienyl ligands, they form 5 molecular orbitals having 3 energy levels. As you know that there are 5 carbon atoms in the cyclopentadienyl ring. So these 5 carbon atoms, total they have 6 electrons, but the carbon atoms or p orbitals are 5. So all these 5 orbitals, they linearly combine to form molecular orbitals. 5 carbon atoms combine, then they will form 5 molecular orbitals having 3 energy levels. So one molecular orbital is the bonding, that is strongly bonding, that is represented by psi 1, and other molecular orbitals, there are 2 molecular orbitals, they are having the similar energy, they are denoted by psi 2 and psi 3. Because they are doubly degenerate, they have 2 energy levels with the same energy, so it is known as E, doubly degenerate is E1, and the others are psi 4 and psi 5. They are having the similar energy, they are 2 orbitals, so they are represented as E. Okay, so E for doubly degenerate. So two orbitals, two molecular orbitals, and one. There are 5 molecular orbitals when the 5 carbon atom or 5 p orbitals of the cyclopentadienyl ligand, they linearly combine, they form 5 molecular orbitals. And these 5 molecular orbitals, they are represented as psi 1, psi 2, psi 3, psi 4, psi 5. So it is strongly sigma bonding, it is weakly sigma bonding, and it is very weakly pi bonding. So the ligand cannot easily form the pi bond. So it is not a pi acceptor ligand. These are the 5 molecular orbitals formed by 5 carbon p orbitals of the cyclopentadienyl ring. So you can see that in this molecular orbital 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, these two are having the same energy. So these are doubly degenerate, so they are represented by E. These are again the doubly degenerated, there are 2 molecular orbitals which are having the same energy. So again they are written as E. 1 and 2 means this is the first doubly degenerate orbitals and this is the second doubly degenerate orbitals. This is represented by psi 1, these are represented by psi 2 and psi 3, and these are represented by psi 4 and psi 5. So total 5 molecular orbitals will be formed. So in this molecular orbital, you can see that all the p orbitals have the same sign. Actually in this molecular orbital, the same sign of the these combining orbitals is on the same side. So it is having the lowest energy because there is a bonding kind of interaction, plus plus interaction. So now here you can see that there is one node. So these two are plus and these two are negative, so there is one node because the sign are changing here. So it creates a node. Like here also there are a positive charge on the lobes that are showing below side, and here positive charge on these lobes is at the upper side. So again there is a node minus and plus. So it has a horizontal node, it has this vertical node. So both orbitals are having the same energy. So they have one node. Now come to this molecular orbital. Here you can see that plus minus plus minus. So here 2 nodes are there, because here plus minus and here also plus minus. So one node is here and one node is here. And in this case also there are plus minus. So one node is here and plus minus, one node is here. This is plus, minus, plus, minus. So it is again having the two nodes. So as we know that as the number of nodes increases, the energy of the orbitals will also increase. So this orbital will have the lowest energy than this one node, the molecular orbitals, then the two node molecular orbitals, they have the energy. So now you can see that I have already told you that there are six electrons in the cyclopentadienyl ring. So these six electrons, they go to the psi 1, psi 2 and psi 3. So six electrons are filled here, and this E2 orbital is generally that remains is empty. Okay, so it has empty antibonding orbital, but due to the high basicity, because it is having the negative charge. So due to negative charge, there are six electrons. So this cyclopentadienyl ring is a good base. It is acting as good pi donor ligand as compared to the pi acceptor ligand. So it generally cannot easily accept electrons in the antibonding molecular orbital because it is a base due to the presence of negative charge. So it form a strong bonding with the help of the psi 1 sigma bonding and weak bonding with the help of psi 2 and psi 3. So it easily donate its electron pair present in the this orbital, psi 1 orbital. And this is the antibonding orbital. We can simply represent this by this, that all are positive on the upper side. Then you can see these are positive. So we can show the positive charge here. They are negative. So we can show the negative charge. So this is representing it easily the node. Now these are two minus. So these are minus. And these three centers are positive. So it is denoted by positive. So one node is there. In this case, you can see that it is positive. So it is positive. It is negative. It is negative. It is positive, it is positive, it is negative, and it is negative. So you can clearly see the two nodes. Here also, plus, these two are plus, this is minus, so this is minus, this is plus, so this is plus, and this is minus, so this is again minus. So again, there are two nodes. So this is the simple representation of the molecular orbitals of cyclopentadienyl ligand. So now we have seen that these five molecular orbitals, they are formed by cyclopentadienyl ion. Now we will see how the bonding in between metal and cyclopentadienyl will takes place. Now this is the molecular orbital arrangement of cyclopentadienyl complex. So when complex formation will takes place, you will see that this is one of the cyclopentadienyl's molecular orbital and this is the molecular orbital of the other cyclopentadienyl ring. So this is actually the molecular orbitals energy level diagram, overlapping diagram for ferrocene. I have shown for metallocenes, which are sandwich type of compounds. It is one cyclopentadienyl ring and it is the other cyclopentadienyl ring, and in between these two cyclopentadienyl rings, the metal orbitals, metal is present there. So you already know that with the ligand orbitals, the metal orbitals with the same symmetry, they will going to overlap to form the bonding. So you can see that this is the bonding orbital. Here all the positive lobes are all present on the upper side. And this is also the same kind of orbital, but here the positive part is on the lower side of this ring. So these two rings, they are present on the upper part and on the lower part of the sandwich compound, and it will search for the same symmetry metal orbital. So you can see that the symmetry match of this molecular orbital, the two molecular orbitals of the two cyclopentadienyl ring, you can see this is the bonding orbital, this is the other bonding orbital which I have shown previously, and this is having one node. Okay, so this is also having one node. So these one node E1 can overlap with the other orbitals of the metal, so they will search for the other orbitals. And here you can see there are two nodes, so it will search for the orbitals having the same symmetry. So actually, after the formation of the molecular orbitals of the ligands, the ligand cyclopentadienyl of one cyclopentadienyl's molecular orbital and the molecular orbital of the other cyclopentadienyl center, they again combine. Because it is a molecular orbital theory, so in molecular orbital theory you have studied that first the ligand orbitals, they combine to form ligand orbitals. Now there are two ligands, one cyclopentadienyl and other cyclopentadienyl. So now these two cyclopentadienyls, they form the new orbitals, and this orbital, which are bonding orbitals, they search for the metal orbital that have the same symmetry as that of this, so that they can easily form the bond. So this is the 4s orbital of metal atom. If we put this metal orbital here, so you can see that there is a positive 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 overlap. So it is a bonding in between s orbital and this a1g. We have named it as A1G, so A1G of the ligand. Now it can also overlap with the, its symmetry is also similar to that of DZ square of the metal center. If we put this DZ square here, so we will find that it has positive lobe here and positive lobe here, so positive and positive on the lower side. So it can also bond with this A1G orbital. So these are the two orbitals of the metal center which are having the same symmetry with this ligand group orbital. Now this is the other ligand group orbital. Here you can see that all the positive lobes in the two cyclopentadienyl ring, they are on the upper side, so that it is having the negative part of this orbital on the lower side, and this ring is having the positive part on the upper side. So which kind of orbital can participate with the bonding with this molecular orbital? That is PZ. Its upper lobe is negative, so it will overlap with these two negative, and this is the positive, so it can overlap with these two positive of this lower cyclopentadienyl ring. So we have to first the ligand orbitals, they will form the ligand group orbital, then they will search for the metal orbitals having the same symmetry, and then they can easily form bond with the orbitals having the same symmetry. Now how we have given the name A1G. So I have already there is a video on irreducible representation in my YouTube channel. So there I have explained what is A, what is 1, what is G for G rate and U for un-G rate. G rate means, you can see that when we go from here to here, okay, so G rate means we go from positive to positive and negative to negative. Actually when we go from here to here, so this is negative lobe and this is also negative. So when we go from here to here, we are going from negative to negative lobe. In this case, this is positive lobe while this is negative lobe. So if we go from here to here, so there the sign is changing from positive to negative, so it is called as U. It is un-G rate. But when the sign of the orbitals, they don't change, they are known as G rate. Like in case of D orbitals, the sign cannot change. So it is G rate type and this is un-G rate type. And what does mean by A? A means it has axis of symmetry. So if we rotate this molecule from this axis. So this molecular orbitals from this axis, we will find the similar orientation. We will get the similar orientation of this molecular orbital. But and if we rotate this molecule by this axis, along this axis, we will find the similar orientation. But if we cut this molecule from this the plane perpendicular to the axis, then we will find that these two are the mirror image of each other, and they are exactly the half mirror image of each other, that are non-superimposable. So it has plane of symmetry, but it has no plane of symmetry because these are superimposable image. Okay, so they are not mirror image of each other. So we have written it as 2 and it as 1. So A means it has axis of symmetry, and 1 or 2, 1 means it has plane of symmetry, and 2 means it has no plane of symmetry. So the naming is according to the to their symmetry. A means singly degenerate. A means singly degenerate. There is also B. B means singly degenerate, but B, in case of B, there is no excess of symmetry. So here excess of symmetry is there. And it is singly degenerate, so it is represented by A. 1 means it has plane of symmetry, and 2 means it has not plane of symmetry. G means center of symmetry. It does not have center of symmetry actually. So the naming is given as per the irreducible representations. Okay. Now we move to the second orbital. So this is the orbital which is having one node. Okay, so this is vertical kind of node. So these two orbitals of two cyclopentadienyl rings, they arrange like this that they are similar. So their positive lobes are upper side, their positive lobes are also on the upper side, their negative poles on the upper side, their negative poles are on the upper side. So this is a kind of orbital. It is E because it is they are doubly degenerate. Doubly degenerate orbitals are there, one E1G and other E1G. So they are doubly degenerate and other is E1U and E1U. So they are also doubly degenerate. So we have shown with the help of E. Now this can overlap with the 3DYJ orbital of the metal. You can see positive lobe. If we put this orbital in between these two orbitals, then this can overlap with this negative pole with this negative with this, and this positive with this. So it has appropriate symmetry to bond with this kind of molecular orbital. Now here is the case where you can see that there are two negative poles on the upper side and two positive poles of this cyclopentadienyl ring on the upper side. Here the two positive lobes are on the upper side while two negative poles are on the upper side. So these are entirely different kind of arrangement, so that these two pentadienyl rings can linearly combine in this manner also. So in this manner, if it is attached, if they linearly combine in this manner, then the orbital that is PY of the metal, it can overlap with this kind of orbital. You can see that positive lobe here. So it can easily combine, and this is negative. So these are two negative lobes of the P orbital. So it can easily fit at here and can form bond with these orbitals. Okay. Now go to the other orbital of this E1G that also have the node, one node, and it is horizontal node. Okay. Now it can overlap with the DXZ orbital of metal, while this kind of E1U, where there is a horizontal node, here the vertical node is there, here the horizontal node is there, but the arrangements are actually different. So in this case, you can see that for this kind of orbital, the px orbital of the metal can easily overlap. Here you can see that the positive poles are on the upper side, while in this case these three are positive on the upper side, but here these three are positive. Okay, so these orbitals, they are different from these E1U orbitals, and these E1G orbitals are different from this E1G orbital. You can easily see these three orbitals are having the positive lobe at the upper side, while these have the negative poles on the upper side. You can see the difference. These are having the positive lobes on the upper side. Here there are the negative lobes on the upper side. These are the same, but these are the different. They are having the different arrangement of p orbitals wave function sign. So this will overlap with the other kind of orbital, and this will overlap with the other kind of orbital. Now the other orbitals, they are antibonding orbitals, E2G orbitals, and these E2G orbitals, they have two nodes, and you can see that this can overlap with the DXY orbital, while this can overlap with the DX square Y square orbital of the metal. And you can easily see the changes here. The nodes are present like this. Here the nodes are present like this. So these are entirely different arrangements, and the other E2U orbitals, they cannot have the metal orbitals having the same symmetry, so they will not going to combine with the metal orbitals. Okay, so now you can see that all the orbitals of the metal have the symmetry matching with the ligand orbitals, like this S orbital पी एक्स ऑर्बिटल, पी वाई ऑर्बिटल, पी जेड ऑर्बिटल, देन डी वाई जेड ऑर्बिटल, डी एक्स जेड ऑर्बिटल एंड देन डी एक्स वाई ऑर्बिटल, डी जेड स्क्वायर एंड डी एक्स स्क्वायर वाई स्क्वायर. सो ऑल द 9 ऑर्बिटल्स दे कैन फॉर्म, दे कैन इन्वॉल्व अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर सिमिट्री इन द बॉन्ड फॉर्मेशन विद द साइक्लोपेंटाडाइनाइल रिंग्स दैट आर टू, वन इज प्रेजेंट एट द below and one is present on the upper side of the metal center, that is sandwich in between these two ligands. So all these orbitals, they are actually bonding orbitals, okay. So, and these are bonding orbitals and these are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So these are the 8 bonding orbitals and you can see that these orbitals, they remain as such, they do not participate in bonding, okay. So they do not participate in bonding and because they have no orbitals having the same symmetry. So the order of, I will show you the energy level diagram of this metallocene, and you will find that these are the bonding orbital. Likewise, the antibonding molecular will also formed. Now this is the molecular orbital diagram of metallocene. Okay, so in this diagram you can see that these are the molecular orbitals of 2 cyclopentadiene like this. So this is the molecular orbitals of 2 cyclopentadiene. You already know that there are 5 type of molecular orbitals formed by 1 cyclopentadienyl. So there are 2 cyclopentadienyl. So there are 2 orbitals. They will combine and form 2 orbitals A1G and A2U. So psi 1, there are 2 orbitals. For psi 2 and psi 3, there are 4 orbitals, because one can form E1G and E1U. So there are 2 E1G and 2 E1U. And in this case, there are 2 psi 3 and psi 4 for 1 cyclopentadienyl. So for 2 cyclopentadienyl, there are 2 E2G and 2 E2U. Okay. So total 10 orbitals are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So total 10 orbitals are there. Why? Because there are 5 carbon atom or 5 orbital with this cyclopentadienyl ring and 5 carbon atom with this cyclopentadienyl ring. So total, if they combine, they will form 10 molecular orbitals. So these are the 10 molecular orbitals of this 2 cyclopentadienyl rings, which are going to bond with the orbitals of metal. So these are the metals of orbitals. Like we form the molecular orbital diagrams of simple ligands, we generally draw the molecular orbital diagram for carbon monoxide. We write here carbon, then oxygen, and in between the molecular orbitals of the carbonyl. So likewise, we have written here the orbitals of 2 cyclopentadienyl rings which are linearly combined, and then on the other side we put the orbitals of metal. And in the center, these are the molecular orbitals of the metallocene. Metal with these 2 cyclopentadienyl rings, they form sandwich metallocenes. So these are the sandwich metallocenes molecular orbitals. Now you can see that they are A1G and A2U. If we write the symmetry of d orbitals in metal ferrocenes or metallocenes, we will find that their grouping is A1G, E1G and E2G. So we can group these orbitals as this, because the orbitals of the metal having the same symmetry, they can be written as the symmetry of ligand. So we have the symmetry of ligand A1G, and A1G means one orbital. It is 1 and G that are S orbital and DZ is square orbital. So here we define it as A1G of the metal orbital. Now the E1G orbitals are those orbitals which are going to bind with the E1G of these cyclopentadienyl. And E2G are the orbitals. We give the name of the metal orbitals as the symmetry of these. because they have the same symmetry as that of orbitals. So first we have given the name to these ligand orbitals, then we have given the name to the metal orbitals, which the orbitals having the same symmetry as that of the ligand, their name is same as that of this, so that they can easily combine. Okay, so it can be grouped as A1G, E1G and E2G. These are actually, they are named as the ligand group orbitals. They are going to overlap with these metal orbitals because they are having the same symmetry, so their name should be same. Now this S orbital, it is called as A1G, and the P orbitals, they are named as A2U and E1U. 2 and 1, 3 orbital, E means 2, A1 means 1. Here also 2 to 4 and 1, 5. So total 5D orbitals are there. Now you can see that A1G of this ligand will combine with the A1G of the metal. So A1G, A1G, when they combine, they will form 2. There are 2 orbitals. So they will form 2 molecular orbitals. One is bonding A1G, okay, and other is anti-bonding A1G. Then A2U will combine. A2U will combine with the A2U. I have shown with this help of this dotted line. So A2U will combine with the A2U of this cyclopentadienyl and form one is bonding and other is antibonding molecular orbital. Okay. Then E1G of this orbital will combine with the E1G orbital of this. So E1G will combine with this. Then they will form 4 orbitals, 2 bonding and 2 antibonding orbitals. Okay, now this is E2U. This is written as E2U U. Okay, so now this E1U orbital will also combine with the E1U of this metal, and then it can form 2 bonding orbitals and 2 antibonding orbitals. These are the antibonding orbitals. So I have shown in the figure you only the bonding orbitals. So likewise, antibonding molecules will also formed, and you have seen that E2U orbital of the ligand, they remain such. Only you have seen that A1G, A2U, E1G, E1U and E2G orbitals of the ligand, they will combine and E2U remain as such. So E2U, these are having the same energy, so they remains as such, they remains non-bonding, and other orbitals, they will going to linearly combine. So you have seen there that there are 8 bonding orbitals. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So there are 8 bonding orbitals. I will again show you the previous diagram. Here you can again recall that 1, 2, A1G, A2U, E1G, E1U, E1G, E1U, they will participate in bonding, and E2G, E2G will participate in bonding, while E2U remain as such. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 bonding orbitals are formed and E2U will remain the same. So likewise, 8 bonding and 8 antibonding will be formed, and this E2U will remain as such. Okay. So in this way, total 19 molecular orbitals will be formed in metallocenes. 8 are bonding up to here. These are bonding, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. These are bonding orbitals, because as you know that these 8 molecular orbitals will be formed in bonding manner, and there are 8 antibonding orbitals, so total 16. 2 are non-bonding, they are 18, and 1 orbital is the A1G. From here, the pi bonding will start, and up to here, the sigma bonding will be there. So this is the sigma bonding, and from here it they become pi bonding. Now you can see that there are 10 electrons with this cyclopentadienyl ligand. So 10 electrons will be in, there are 12 electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. There are 12 electrons, because one cyclopentadienyl ring is having the 6 electrons and other is having the 6 electrons. So total 12 electrons are there. So 12 electrons will be going to fill up to E1U bonding orbitals. Now you can see that E2g, A1g and E1g, they remains empty. So from E2g, the orbitals will remains empty. So you can see that up to here there are 12 electrons, so they are filled. So these are the ligand orbitals. Okay, so total ligand orbitals are 12 and these are the 12 orbitals. Now the filling of the orbitals from here, it depends upon the number of electrons present in the metal orbital. Okay, so up to E1u, up to those 8 bonding orbitals, the up to these 6 orbitals, bonding orbitals, out of 8 bonding orbitals, the 12 electrons, they came from the cyclopentadienyl ligand. And from this E2g, the filling of electrons will depends upon the configuration of d orbital, and it also depends upon the difference between this E2g A1g and A1g and EG star. I will show only this portion of this diagram for different kind of metallocene, because up to this there are 12 electron, and after this the filling of electrons will going to depend upon the configuration of metal. Now you can see the part that is above the E2g. I have already told you, because below the T2g the electrons, the total number of electrons is 12. Okay, so now we have taken the vanadocene. Actually the metallocene name is according to the metal center present in the cyclopentadienyl complex. So this is a cyclopentadienyl complex where I have changed the metal. Here the metal is V. Two cyclopentadienyl rings are represented by CP2. One CP is for cyclopentadienyl, so two for two cyclopentadienyl, and V is the metal center. So this because in these metallocenes the cyclopentadienyl is having two negative charge, so the metal will have two positive charge. So due to two positive charge, because the electronic configuration of vanadium is 3d3 4s2, so because it becomes v2 plus, so configuration will become 3d3. So below this there are 12 electrons. You already know that below this which orbital was present, the E1u orbitals were present. So in the up to E1u 12 electrons were there. So above this E1u there are 3 orbitals, E2g, A1g star and E1g star. So these 3 electrons on V2 plus, they are present in the EG set. You can see that this is vanadocene. It is a 15 electron system, because below this there are 12 electrons and plus 3 there are 15 electrons, because it is existing as plus 2. So 12 electrons of this and 3 electrons of this, they become 15 electron system, and it is paramagnetic because of presence of this unpaired electron. So we can also tell about its magnetic behavior of metallocenes with the help of the molecular orbital diagrams of metallocenes. Now in case of this is chromocene. Chromocene means in this the metal center is chromium, and in this metal center you can see that if we take the chromium second ion, then its electronic configuration will become 3d4. 3d4, and this in this chromium you can see that the difference between this E2g and A1g is very less. In this case, this difference is very less. In these three cases, actually, in these two cases, actually, in case of Mn, the difference between this energy level is also very less. There are the difference in the energy levels of the different metal center. These are two exceptions. In all other metals, there are the differences in between these orbitals are almost similar. But in case of chromium, the difference between E2g and A1g is very small, while the difference between these two orbitals with the E1g star is very high. So filling of electron will be different in case of chromocene, so that first electron, second electron, third electron and then fourth electron. So the filling of electrons will take place like this. If it is taking place like this, then the electron pair, the electron will be paired and it become diamagnetic. But the chromosine is paramagnetic in nature. It is a 16 electron system, 12 electron up to E1U, and 4 electrons are present in the upper part of the diagram. And here, because there is the difference between E2G and A1G is very less, so electrons filling will takes place like this: 1, 2, 3, and 4. So it is paramagnetic, and it is having the 2 unpaired electron. Now come to the Mn. So if Mn is high spin complex, in case of Mn, the high spin complex, the energy difference between these orbitals is very low. So that electron filling will takes place like this: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So all the 5 electrons are unpaired and it become paramagnetic in nature. But in case of low spin complex, if we replace the Cp by Cp star, so what does Cp star means? Cp star means the H groups, they are replaced by methyl group. So Cp star means C5H Me5. So if we have taken this kind of ligand, then it becomes strong ligand and the complex will become low spin, because the difference between this A1G and E1G star, it become much higher. So that the electron will not go to this E1G star. Electrons will pair here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So all the electrons, they are present in these orbitals, so that it become paramagnetic, but it is less paramagnetic as compared to the high spin complex, and it is magnesine. Both are magnesine. Their name is magnesine because they are metallocenes. So their exception is there for chromium and manganese. You can see the difference in their orbitals energy. Okay. Now come to the ferrocene. Ferrocene and this cobaltocene. If you see both in both cases, they are 18 electron systems. Fe2 plus and this is CO3 plus. So both are having the 6 electrons in the D configuration. So 12 electron up to E1U and 6 electrons are present here, so that it become diamagnetic in nature. So it is a 18 electron system. So this actually it came through the NET exam mainly. They ask about the total electron system and their magnetic behavior. Okay. Now come to the cobaltocene. So in case of cobaltocene, it is 3d7. It is having the 3d7 configuration, cobalt second. So 12 electrons are filled up to E1U, and the other 7 electrons, they are filled like this. So it is paramagnetic in nature because it is having 1 unpaired electron. Now come to the nickelocene. Nickelocene is a 20 electron system because it is having 3d10 configuration. So it is paramagnetic in nature due to presence of these 2 unpaired electrons. So the electron spilling takes place after this, because there is a gap between E2G and this A1G and E1G star. So only the exceptions are chromosine and manganese, where you can see that in case of manganese, all the orbitals are very near to each other, and thus it is paramagnetic in nature. But in case of chromosine, the difference between E2G and A1G is very small, while that in between A1G and E1G is higher. So the electronic arrangement will be like this, and electronic arrangement will be like this. So this electronic arrangement will also tells about the stability or reactivity of these metallocenes. Now we can give the gist of this, the molecular orbital energy level diagram of different metallocenes like this, that in case of ferrocene and cobaltocene, so in this case you can see they are 18 electron system. So if the species is 18 electron, it is coordinatively saturated species, and it is stable species because its valence electrons, they become 18, and it is near to the noble gas configuration. All the orbitals are filled. Now come to the cobaltocene and nickelocene. So in case of cobaltocene, the electrons are more than 18. It has 19 electron, it has a 20 electron system. So because they have more than 18 electrons, so they are very reactive and they are paramagnetic in behavior, while these are diamagnetic in behavior. Now come to the vanadocene and chromosine. So in case of vanadocene and chromosine, they have less than 18 electron system. So again, they are very reactive. They are reactive. This vanadocene is having 15 electron system and it is 16 electron system, so they are coordinatively unsaturated compounds and they are reactive in nature. Now come to magnenosine. In case of magnenosine, the high spin complex, it has 5 unpaired electrons. And it is paramagnetic in nature, so it is very reactive in nature. So their reactivity can be defined with the help of the number of electrons present in them. It is a 17 electron species, okay, because 5 plus 12 is 17 electron species. So again, it is very reactive. So reactivity can be defined with the help of how many electron system is the metallocene. Now come to the bent metallocene. So I have shown you the molecular orbital diagram of bent metallocene, where you will see the difference between the two. I will give two example of two bent metallocene, and where you will see the about their reactivity with the help of their molecular orbital diagrams. So these are the molecular diagrams, molecular energy level diagram of two bent metallocene. So I have given the example of titanosine dihalide, dichloride, and this is molybdenosine dihalide, this is dichloride. So you can compare these two bent metallocenes molecular orbital energy level diagram. So come to the titanosine. Actually if we take this titanosine's molecular orbital will contain the one side, it is the metallocene titanosine, and on the other side the two other ligands are there. So chlorine is one electron donor, so it has one electron in each chlorine atom there is one unpaired electron, so two chlorine atom will have two unpaired electrons, okay, because it is more electronegative, so its energy orbitals they are of lower energy as compared to this metallocene. This is titanosine. And in case of titanosine, you will see that in each set there will be two electron, because in titanosine state is plus 2, so plus 2 titanium is 3d2. So 3d2 configuration I have shown you. I have not given the example of titanosine actually. So here I am giving you the example in the previous portion. You have seen that there are three orbitals below this, there are 12 electrons, and from here the metal electrons will start filling. So there are two electrons with the metal titanium second, so two electrons are there and two electrons are with the chlorine. So when these two they are linearly combined, they will form the titanosine dichloride. So you can see that these 1, 2 orbital and 3, 4 orbital, when they combine they will form such kind of orbitals. So we have shown the small portion of this diagram. So all the four electrons they are going to filled in these bonding orbitals, okay. When these will combine, they will form four orbitals, 1, 2, 3, 4. So four will combine to form four orbital, 1, 2, 3, 4 actually. This is the single orbital. There are other orbitals which are not shown in this diagram. So these four orbitals will be going to filled in this bonding orbital of titanosine dihalide. So it becomes 16 electron system. It has 14 electrons, 12 plus 2, 14, and 2 from chlorine, so it becomes 16 electron system. Okay, now come to the molybdenum complex, and you will see that there are 4 electrons in the MOCP2. Molybdenosine has 4 plus 12, 16 electron system, and 2 chlorine has 2 electrons, so it becomes 18 electron system. Okay, so filling of electrons will takes place like this. All the electrons are paired, but it is an 18 electron system and it is a 16 electron system. And due to the 16 electron system, it is coordinatively unsaturated compound, so it is a hard Lewis acid and it can easily react with pi basic ligands like OR. Okay, now come to the molybdenosine dihalide, which is 18 electron system. It is having the sufficient electrons, so it is a soft pi base. It is a base, so it can easily react with the pi acceptor ligands like C2H4. So this will affect their reactivity. So it can easily react with pi acceptor ligand because it has filled electrons, so it can back donate its electrons to the pi acceptor ligands easily. It is electron deficient, so it can form bond with the pi base ligand, which can give their pi electrons to the metal center. So this kind of reactivity they will show. These are some preparation methods of sandwich metallocenes. So first method is, it can be prepared from cyclopentadienyl compounds, in which the cyclopentadienyl is present as Cp minus. So this is a salt of cyclopentadienyl sodium salt. When it reacts with the metal halide, it can form sandwich compound, that is ferrocene. Now it can be synthesized from the compounds containing cyclopentadienyl as Cp plus. So this is a compound in which there is a bromine, so it will act like a positive part. So this is C5H5 plus, so it can react with this kind of compound and then can form ferrocene. The other method is from diene. It can also synthesize from cyclopentadiene ligand, and when this react with cyclopentadiene ligand, then it can easily form the piano stool type metallocene. Then some characteristics, chemical reaction. So chemical reaction, it can easily react with nitrosyl. So when it reacts with nitrosyl, one this cyclopentadienyl ligand will be replaced by this NO. Then it can easily react with phosphine ligand. It can react with different kind of ligand. So when it react with phosphine ligand, all the phosphine ligands they replace the cyclopentadienyl ring. So such kind of compound will be obtained. Then reaction with carbonyl, it can easily react with carbonyl, and the carbonyl it comes to the bridging portion of the nickel metallocenes. Then reaction with H plus ion, it can easily react with H plus ion to form such kind of product. Now come to the conclusion part of the cyclopentadienyl complexes. So this cyclopentadienyl complexes, actually they are of three types. One are sandwich type, and other are half bent, and third one is this piano stool type. Piano stool type, I have given you the examples. Then cyclopentadienyl is actually 6 electron system, and when it reacts with metals, then they can form three type of complexes that are known as, generally they are known as metallocenes. Then in this chapter we have shown the about the bonding. In the bonding, you have seen that these cyclopentadienyl 6 carbon atom, they first linearly combine to form 5 molecular orbitals with 3 combinations, psi 1, psi 2, psi 3, and psi 4 psi 5. And these 5 orbital, when they combine with the 5 orbitals of other cyclopentadienyl, then they again form 10 molecular orbitals. And out of these 10 orbitals, 8 orbitals can combine with the metal orbitals having the similar symmetry. In this way, they form 8 bonding orbitals and 8 antibonding orbitals and 3 other orbitals, 2 non-bonding E2U and 1 A1G orbital. So total 19 molecular orbitals will be going to form, and up to E1U there will be the filling of ligand or electrons, that are 12 electrons, and above this, that is E2G, A1G and E1G, and that orbitals, the electrons filling depends upon the configuration of metal center. So I have shown you the magnetic behavior and the reactivity of different metallocenes. Okay, so like in a case of vanadocene, it is a 15 electron system, and this chromium chromocene is 16 electron system, so they are paramagnetic in nature. Likewise, this magnenocene is also paramagnetic in nature, and it is 17 electron system. So the systems actually which are having the more than 18 electron or less than 18 electron, they are reactive as compared to the 18 electron system. And the examples of 18 electron systems were ferrocene and cobaltocene, and other metallocenes are very reactive. And then we have seen the the molecular orbital diagram of bent metallocene, and I have given you example of titanosine dihalide and molybdenosine dihalide, and you have seen that the titanosine dihalide was 16 electron system while the molybdenosine dihalide was 18 electron system. So due to 18 electron system it is a good base, while due to 16 electron system titanosine dihalide is 16 electron system. So they can show the difference in their reactivity pattern. Then we have seen we have studied the preparation method and different properties of cyclopentadienyl ring. And this cyclopentadienyl we will also discuss in the fluxional behavior, that all the 5H atoms of the cyclopentadienyl ring actually they show fluxional behavior as that of allylic hydrogen atoms. So that will be discussed in the fluxional behavior of cyclopentadienyl ligand. So this is all about cyclopentadienyl complexes. Thank you very much.